best loss are, and I'll talk more about program building and stuff like that later, and what I really feel about this loss. But for today, for our guys and for the fans, it's a pretty big day. First time our guys are down the weight, so we'll be prepared for next week when we open up the schools. And, you know, just putting this coaching clinic together, and then obviously the football game tonight. There's a lot of buzz around this campus right now. So we have four recruits on campus that are really, really important to us in this program. We got a lot going on. We appreciate you guys getting up early, getting up here or down here, wherever you come from, and spending the morning with us. We're going to start with Donny and his leg attack series. Donny obviously is pretty good. He won a couple of district championships. It's a joke. He's a four-time All-American, a world team member, world finalist, or world bronze medalist. Second year with our program. He's wrestled in the Big Ten. He's coached in the Big Ten. He really knows what this whole conference is about. And he's very good at what he does, so I strongly recommend you have your cameras out, video this stuff. You don't mind being videoed, right, Coach? And I volunteered to be the dummy, since our guys are all wrestling. Really, our whole program is wrestling today, so there's nobody else that can be the dummy. So I'm going to play dummy today and let Donnie take over. And then what we'll do is we'll go, Coach Leonardis is going to do mat work. He's going to show a single wrist series. And guys, just so you know, any questions, any specific area, any specific situation, we can touch on everything. We can touch on everything. So it doesn't have to be, you know, us showing technique, and we just, questions please ask. We put you in a certain situation, and basically what we do, we'll talk about what we do and some of the things we've watched. Obviously, coming off these world championships last month, there's a lot of technique out there. There's a lot of really, really good stuff out there. But at the end of the day, if you watch the national tournament, the highest level of this sport, single leg, double leg, to go behind, to protect your legs, and in college wrestling, to be really, really tough on top. If you're really, really tough on top, and you could punish somebody, ride somebody, and any turns to that, are the rules the same in high school? We're a 4-point near fall now.
No.
In college. Yeah. So college, it's a 4-point near fall. 4-point near fall, which is awesome. So we have some guys that are, hopefully you see today, are really, really good on top. And if they turn you from a 4-count, it's 4 points. So that's huge. We had preliminary matches the other day, and I didn't know it was going to be that big a deal, but we had a guy winning 7-4, third period, takedown, cradle to his back for a 4-count. He was got choked, called out, ended up being a knockout, then he got a choice on the bottom, and reversed him, ended up being a 9-minute play. Within 10 seconds, I went from 7-4 to whatever, 13 second match over. So it's quick. So I guess what I'm trying to say is being really good on top is really, really important. And we'll talk about that today with Coach Leonardis and go over that single wrist. Enough of me talking. We'll let Donnie come on in and get going with this series.
I know what I want to show as far as like the system. I'm going to show singles and head positions, setups, and then finishing. But as I'm going along, if you guys have questions, like Scott said, I want to be geared towards what you guys want, because I can stand up for 2 hours and just go over the wrestling that I like to show. But if there's questions that you guys have, I have no problem taking a turn and going a different round. So as I get going, you guys have questions. Please steer me in the direction you want to go. So I'll show things that I recognize how the case is here, and I'll probably show a lot of the things that maybe you've seen me show before, maybe a few different wrinkles, but I believe in very basic technique, very basic positions, and then just being brilliant at those basics. And I think, you know, you guys are all high school coaches, youth coaches, and you know, I'm not really into teaching fancy moves and flashy technique. I like very basic, simple things that everybody can do, and to me that's flashy. When I see a guy that's very solid and wrestles in great position and doesn't give anything an inch, is able to attack both sides of the body and just understands the basic principles of the sport, to me that's flashy. So that's the way I teach. I can answer any questions. I can go off on anything might have. So as I'm going through, you know, if you guys have questions, please have me, help me figure out what's going to be the best interest of you guys in making this successful. So, high. All right, bringing the leg up high. I'm going to finish it at mid-range, where I try to sit them, or I'm going to belt them. All right, and then also probably the biggest thing, and the most important area, is when I shoot, right, especially in high school, and the guy, maybe my setup isn't 100% crisp, and then I get stuck underneath them. I get stuck underneath them and just learning how to, you know, leverage myself, get my shoulder and my head and my body in position so I can finish the shot when I get extended, because probably, you know, 75% of your guys, maybe even more, are going to get to a guy's leg. They're going to be sprawled on, they're going to be extended, and it's just a matter of if they understand how to fight the position. Some of them aren't developed, their cores aren't strong, so learning the body position and the mechanics can really help that. You know, I think, you know, most high school guys are kind of long and lanky, you know, and they just don't have that core strength, that hip strength, that stomach strength that they really need. So learning how to use their knees and different body parts. Starting off, I always like that control arm to an attack arm. All right, my control arm is going to be my back arm. All right, so I'm a right leg lead, so my control arm is my left hand, my back hand. All right, so I'm gonna reach at that. I'm gonna engage him with that. All right, as I make contact with my head. All right, I'm a real big believer in using your head as a weapon. All right, I want to be able to dig my head into his forehead. I never want to let him get lower than me, all right? That's just a basic principle of never letting him lower than me, so he can't get to my legs, and also I have a better line of vision to get to his, all right? I love leg attacks, all right? I can score when a guy shoots on me, of course, and I'm going to sprawl and work on all those things as well, but I firmly believe that wrestling, high school wrestling and college wrestling, is a leg attack sport. The guys that attack the legs are the guys that are going to win. All right, so I have to be low. All right, my head position is paramount. We talk about it all the time, all right, with our guys, head position. And it's hard to get a young wrestler, maybe a high school wrestler just starting out, who want to go in there and dig his head in, you know, dig his head and run it across the guy's forehead. You know, but I think it's really important. All right, it's really important to be able to have that head position. I never want Scott to go over. I always want to be at head level, right, go lower, right, and ideally, I have him on tilt. My head's in his neck, all right, my head's in his neck, and I'm carving down this inside control, all right. The lower I can get towards the elbow, the better, I have better control, all right, so I can move this by, and I can also pull, all right, which I'm going to do to get to my shot, all right. So as I go in with my head position, my control arm, my back arm is reaching as well. I'm getting this inside thigh. And I'm moving my head. All right, I turn my head, and that helps me clamp down in this tie. All right, my head's right on his neck, right in his ear, right in his head here, whatever. All right, and my arm's coming down. I'm pulling. I'm going to control with my control arm. All right, simple enough. My control arm does the control. He can stay there. It's going to slingshot me into the shot. All right, my attack hand, my lead leg hand, all right, that's going to do the snapping, the popping, the faking. All right, ultimately, that's the hand. Alright, so my first setup, I just always like to go inside tiny wrist. Inside tiny wrist, that's my favorite thing to get to. When I grab the wrist, I go thumb to the outside. If I can, ideally, I control his whole hand by my thumb and his palm. Boom, right down. And it's just a tug. You'll see a lot of young guys, they think they can pull it. I can't really pull him. I'm going to tug it, and then there's my shot. It's a hard tug, head position. Hard tug, set my feet, and then there's my penetration. Hard tug, set my feet. All right, now we work on that a lot, that footwork of it, where I'm circling opposite where I want him to set. All right, so I'm circling away from the leg I'm going to shoot to. All right, and as I circle, I split step, and then most of my penetration is a knee drop over the top right to his toe, and I'm swinging around. All right, so it's not your basic penetration. You guys are starting practicing about 3 weeks. You're going to do a lot of heel toe, knee, double leg, head, double leg, high cross penetration. This is more of a split step where I'm stepping, my back leg comes back, right, I'm going to drive off it, and I penetrate mostly over my knee, my chest is over my knee, and then I swing. I swing to the outside. I don't want to leave my trail leg behind. All right, so again, head position.
position, moving in inside tie. I got the wrist. I'm gonna pull, set my feet. Pull, set my feet. Then I'm back stepping. Back stepping. Knee goes forward, right towards his toe. And I swing to the outside. My shoulder stays in front, and I'm leaning on him. And I like to shoot my hand right underneath his kneecap. Alright, my trail leg, I don't want to keep it in front of me here. Alright, swing it to the outside. We're all facing the same wall. I drive up to my feet. Alright, any questions in there? On the set? Nothing. Alright, also, I can just pop his head. Alright, instead of going to his wrist, instead of getting to his wrist, alright, I'll pull this wrist, then I'll pop his head and go. Alright, so I like to do that too. But again, it starts from head position. So when I'm moving into my partner, we're head to head. I'm attacking my head into his neck and this inside tie. Alright? I think it also, if you start your season this way, if you engage with your partner, it avoids this wrestling. You know, in high school, you see this a lot. Not much can happen here. You know, unless I got a really good duck. Alright, so. Learning how to wrestle in a little bit of space. Now we talk about finding the perfect distance. I don't want to be too far out, right, where I shoot and then shoot is too far away. And I don't want to be too tight where everything I do he can feel. All right, so I'm keeping my control arm controlling his tricep, and my head is on the opposite side of my shot. All right, I'm keeping a good distance. So he's biting on my face as I move, and I set him. All right, but I'm not too tight where he can feel everything I'm doing. All right, make sense? So wrist, head pop. I also like to twist the guy. All right, I'll twist him so my thumb block right in the crook of his elbow. All right, I'm trying to shove this into his hip. All right, I'm gonna try to shove his elbow back into his hip. Alright, so he'll kind of fight back a little bit, and here's my shot. Alright, so I'm kind of using that twist together. Alright, also just to create some action, I might move his elbow by. Alright, I think this is a really good skill to teach your guys. Alright, because if I'm snapping my power hand, my attack hand, if I'm snapping and I'm moving his elbow by, that's going to get him to grab me hard. Here's my shot. Alright, so I'm kind of working both sides. I'm getting him to react, but I also have a high crouch. All that. I can just get his elbow moved by. Alright, there's a lot of technique that goes into moving his body. Scott's holding me tight. Alright, he's holding me tight. I gotta move to the outside. So again, I take that step to the outside and I lift my elbow up. As I'm pushing down. Alright, so I'm lifting my elbow up. As I push down, all right, maybe my shot's here, maybe he squares on me. He squares, there's my center. So it's a good little combination of being able to attack both sides. All right, and also keeping him, he's thinking, he's defensive minded there. He's not thinking about offense. All right, so that's good for me. Any questions on that? On those hand positions? Yeah. I want to put my head on this side. Right? My single is my best shot, personally. And I just think it's easier to finish when I get to a single leg than on each side. So what I do is I put my head on this my high crop side. So he feels threatened. And I'm coming that way, I even circle that way. And then I swing. Right? So most people want head position on the same side when they shoot. Right? So I have Scott thinking about this leg, all right? Now, can I get to it yet? I can get to it, but I'd rather go swing, easier finish, all right? But, you know, I don't know if I'm answering the question, but if I move this arm by, right, I push this elbow by, there's a high single, there's a knee pull on that side. If he bites that hard on me, I can pull it by too. So I'm inside kind of position. He's slanting that hard. I think I'm trying to pull this back. Alright, he fights inside. There's a lot of good wrestling I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do everything I can to keep my elbow in position so he can't get inside. And my head's doing a good job too. But if he does get inside, good. He fights in. My elbow pulls my hat out. Personally, I'd rather go to my single. Right? But I'm in good position to get to that lead leg because I'm circling that way and my head's in position. My head's in position. He's low. I'm going to be able to get to that. The other change is so hard to do is hit this one. I know you're getting this side, how you're getting this side. I think while I'm pulling it, this other change.
Your guys will feel it though, you know, because all your pressure, you know, anytime I've done clinics, the guys that go out of my shoulders have my head here, so I can shoot. It's actually more natural to have your head on the other side, because this guy, he's naturally, even if this leg's far, he's naturally protecting his side, especially because I'm circling towards it, and as I circle towards it, I set my feet, that back one's going to come around. You should definitely be teaching your guys to attack both sides of the body, especially because it is so wide open. If he's a hard right leg lead, right, and I have head position, my high drop is there. You know, I just think it's very hard. It's much harder to teach your team, your high school team, to finish a high drop than you do the same. Everybody's super corner. It's not even high. Not
everybody thinks high crotch is great. Everybody scored off that defensive, beating the corner on it. So you got to be really good in there and get an athlete and get up, get chest up, get some height, and finish a good high crotch. This is becoming more of a, I don't want to say a risk, but it's a risk.
Okay. Anything else in there?
So as I hit my shot, my first thing I want to do is I want to get this leg up high. I bring it up high. That's not my best position to finish from. All right, so as I bring it high, you know, a lot of the times I'm going to be stuck in that mid-range. All right, he's good. He's fighting me. All right, so I'm going to, the first thing I'm going to show is finishing that mid-level. Because a good wrestler, they're going to start fighting you. All right, they're going to start fighting you. And, you know, a lot of times during the year, especially in this preseason, we work a lot on setups and getting the guy in, but most of the things we work on is our guys are good enough now, we know they're going to get to the legs. Right? Now finishing has become very difficult. So to take away from the hand fighting and guys still standing and spend 30 seconds pulling on each other before they shoot, we'll just have that lunge in.
More reps.
So getting more reps, and you know, if we're going a 2 minute go, I'm just lunging into my position. Right, I'm lunging into my single. All right, my shoulder's in front. I try to, you know, wherever that ASIC side is, boom. I try to handle him with my shoulder. I snake my arm down underneath his kneecap. Right, my knee's right where it's gonna be at the time, and I'm driving up to my feet. All right, I drive up to my feet. I use my knee as a shelf. All right, it's a shelf. Once I get up to my feet, I'm locking. Right, I'm locked, my backhand's on top. All right, my backhand's on top. I don't like to keep this underhand on top. It's easier for him to split my lock. Right, I don't have the same pressure where I can drive that forward. I can't drive as much forward. My lock's on top, I get more pressure on his knee and his hip. Alright, so again, I'm lunging in. He's catching the shot. He's being a good partner. He's catching the shot. Right? My swing leg, I don't want it in front. I want it to the side, facing the same wall. I'm leaning on him hard. I'm learning this position. I drive up. Alright, now from this position, if he's fighting me hard and his heel's starting to come back and I'm losing it, I'm gonna sit up. Alright? Most of the time I won't get him down to the mat. It's just a chance for me to readjust. So my outside leg steps in, I'm gonna pull this in between my legs as I circle. Alright, lower my level. Alright, if he goes down, great, then I cover. Alright? Most guys, they stay up. When he stays up, then I'm As I sit him, he stays up. Now's the chance for me to readjust. All right? And I'm going to drop my lock hand that's on the bottom down to his ankle. And I'm going to pull this across my belt. All right? It's right across my waist like it's a belt. All right? And then from this position, I start to climb the leg, staying low, and get my takedown. So I work those two together from the mid-level finish. All right? I'm drying off, trying to sit him. The big thing, a lot of our guys make this mistake, is as they drive up, they're in position, and then when I go to sit stop, they get frustrated, right, and then they kind of sit like that. That's poor technique. All right, turns it into a 50-50 position. All right, I want to pull that leg. I want to step in, circle, and pull his leg down. And I want him to fall and me to cover him. So this is a big position. So I think, you guys should spend a lot of time on this. This area, when I get up, I'm in a good position in my single. All right, these guys have gotten so good at defense here, whether it's diving through or just heel back, fighting the lock, you know, whatever it is, I gotta keep him moving. I just can't stay still. So stepping in my outside leg, sitting him, that knocks him off balance, then I can drop to that belt. All right, I'm using my chest, turn his knee forward. His knee's up, I can't turn it. I'm using my chest to turn his knee forward, and I'm pushing his toe down. So, I sit, I drop, I'm using my chest and my stomach, turn that knee forward and down. I don't want it up. All right, his knee's up, that's when he can get it. He can square up to me. All right, so I want to turn that, or kick the hip, turn that down, control that leg. And now I'm not safe here either. I gotta close the gap between my head and the mat, stay low, and attack that far leg. All right, because guys are rolling. These guys are rolling everywhere you go. You know, they're trying to grab an ankle, trying to force a ceiling.
One thing that really goes unnoticed in this technique, guys, as I'm feeling right now, is that shoulder pressure. He's got me so good with his shoulder. It's just really, really good position. And then the second thing is, I think we should talk about, especially for this, for the high school level, when we do the clinics, I say 3 feet together, they're really not together. If you see Donny comes up, he doesn't step out of it. He has 3 feet in good position. And that's, so stop our guys. Okay, 3 feet, I'm in good position, now I can finish.
Yeah, a good drill to practice that too, is they're starting, they drive in. Now you work on straddling with your knees. My shoulder's peeking through, my shoulder's on top of his hip. I put my hands behind my back, I don't need my hands. Like moving. And I'm circling both directions. And there's a lot of weight on it. I'm leaning over the top. You know, so, and then you push that guy away, you're in your stance. So it's the same position as being in your stance. Right now you just have his leg. So I think that's really important. We don't want to stay in front of the guy. I shoot a single. If I'm in front of him here, I'm gonna lose the position. Too much weight on it. You know, so we talked a lot about hip to hip. Getting hip to hip, whether I'm on my knees trying to finish, which we'll get to, or if I'm up in the air. Now I'm up in the air and on this single. I don't want, my toes are pointed towards him right now. I need to readjust him, so this is when I'll sit him. I sit him, get hip to hip. And all their toes are in a row. All right? Now I'm always protecting this front one. Because if he's long and scrambly, he'll try to grab my ankle, or come underneath, or dive through. All right, so at a moment's notice, I'm always ready to drop my knee down so you can't get to it. All right? Any questions in there? But I really like that drill. I did this when I was a kid in my club. I was in on the leg, straddling the leg, right? Just learning how to move the guy 30 seconds, go get a clip. And I'm in, I get to my position, I straddle, I'm pinching my knees. This is my perfect position. I don't even need my hands. You know, it's great for young guys. It's a lot of pressure on them. And it really teaches them to lock in that position and get comfortable with that shoulder on top. You know, I think kids have a tendency, they go to their feet and they want to hug this leg. My position actually deteriorates here. My head's going down, my shoulder's to the outside. He starts fighting me, I'm in trouble. So I don't really want to hug that leg. I want to keep my shoulder over the top, and I'm leaning on it. It's good pressure, good stretch.
So, if nothing else, you learn that position. It's worth it. From there, you know, maybe I can't reach, go backside. All right, so I'll bring the leg high. All right, when I finish high, we've added a new wrinkle this year with our guys, just to watch our world championships. As I drop to bring the leg high, I'm trying to cover his ankle. I'm gonna try to cover his ankle with my forearm, right at his heel. All right, so I want really want to focus on keeping his knee up, right, his toe up. I don't want him to have any flexibility. All right, and we've really been trying to focus our guys on controlling the bottom part of his foot, or the bottom part of his leg, so he can't dive through. All right, a guy can only move leg, a guy can only dive, right, if he has flexibility in his hip and his knee. If I control his heel and his toes, he's not gonna be able to dive through. And right now, I'd say it's like the age of spaghetti wrestling, where at any level, except for probably freestyle, guys can't dive as much. Guys are diving all over the place. These kids are willing to do backflips and front flips and anything they could possibly do just to slow a guy down or cause a stalemate, or, you know, maybe that's the only way they're going to have to score. So the more I can really control this position, the better off I am. I'm not a big fan of spaghetti wrestling. I really want to get to a leg, control it, and show my dominance that way. All right, so as I drive up, I'm in this position. Maybe I sit him. He's fighting hard. I try to sit him. Now, as I drop low, bring it high, right, my bottom hand slides. It's going right to his heel, and my forearm and my elbow are turning his knee, right, and his toe up. All right, there's a lot more pressure on. Right, instead of coming in this position, you know, I was showing this in years. Right, then I got to the point where I was just showing, keep your elbow high. And now, your elbow's high, and it's also catching his instep. All right, so there's a lot of weight on his hip. There's not much flexibility where he can dive.
There's not much flexibility anyway, so be easy with
that. So there's not much flexibility for him to be able to, you know, move his knee. Right, there's a lot of guys that are doing this now. Right here, he's in, I'm whipping my leg out, right? Or they're diving through. But all that comes from being able to, you know, manipulate your knee and your hip. You know, you can't do that if he's controlling your toe. You know, so I think it's something that's really worth it. If he's practicing a single, right, and I am gonna try to lift and go high, when I drop, I do a little extra. Heel, elbow to the toe, boom. I hope you guys go back and teach all your kids to do this and jumping through the middle and all that funk wrestling is completely eliminated from wrestling. So, I mean, that's my goal. Any questions in there? Alright, so that's basically, as I lift that high, I shoot. Alright, and then I drop. Elbow, heel, high. I'm not coming back with this hand and jacking it up high. It's steady pressure. From the point when I start, when I bump him to lift, it's just steady pressure high. Oh yeah, maybe the guy isn't flexible. But right here, he can't dive on me either. He dives on me, his season's over. All right, I got his knee locked down in good position. All right, so I sweep him. As I step in, I sweep. All right, so that's a good skill holder step. Steps on close, boom, sweep. All right, I'm not trying to hook. I'm not trying to step and hook like that. All right, where I step in, I shuffle, sweep. Boom, and I'm lifted. Not him, because I'm pretty nice to him.
I get used to your guys too, right now. Finish right now. Don't wait. The more you sit around and wait in that position, the more of this we're getting, the more of the funks and all that.
Any questions out up in the air? Finishing up in here, mid level.
Shoot wizard,
heel. I'm coming to shoot now. He's in a sprawl, so it's our third area. First one, either mid level, where I'm moving the guy and stump him, or I belt myself, or bring it high. Most of your guys are probably going to end up in this position where they're wrestling, they're moving, and they're going to take a shot and be aggressive.
they get caught underneath, you got it. Alright, so boom. I shoot, I get caught underneath. Alright? Now, this is important that your partner's doing a good job. Alright, you gotta teach your guys to be good partners. So we'll
even start where he's standing up. And Scott's working on catching the shot. Alright, again, this is just to get reps. So he's going maybe like 50, 60%. Giving a good feel on the defense. And I'm going all out. All right, I'm working on getting to the corner. Getting to the corner, working to get hip to hip. No shin whizzer. All right, no shin whizzer at this point, because I'm really going to really practice keeping my shoulder by that A6 sign and up his hip and all my weight into it. All right, so as I lunge in, I know he's catching the shot. All right, so
I know he's catching that shot. All right, my shoulder's staying on him. I can't leave this leg behind. I leave it behind, he clasps my hips, I'm in trouble. Right, a real long guy, he'll catch my foot, right, and score on me. Right, so I'm really concentrating on working hip to hip. Working to get my hip to his hip. Right, so I'm hitting, I'm catching, I'm circling, I'm posting. All right, I'm getting off my knees. I'm off my knees, I'm pile driving my shoulder into his hip. All right, so I'm really driving his leg down to the mat. All right, and then what I'm gonna do is re-penetrate with my knee all the way around. So as I circle into him, I'm gonna re-penetrate with my knee, get hip to hip, I control the position, and then I bring it up to the shelf, and I attack. All right, so the partner has to catch the shot, all right, give him a good feel, all right. My hand position doesn't change a whole lot. If I can, I'd like to keep it down, snake down. If he's really throwing hard, and I slide, that's okay. All right, I'm never gonna sacrifice body position for hand position. I'm not staying locked. You know, you'll see it today.
You'll see it today in our first match. He's being sort of got out of here. But really Scott and Peyton, they're gonna get to a leg, and they're never gonna let go. That's not what we teach. But they're so flexible on their shoulders, and they haven't figured it out yet. If the guy's throwing hard on you, you gotta post. You gotta post to maintain good position. You know, I see a lot of these guys that are shooting, just to hang on, they're holding, they take a lot of punishments. You know, their shoulders take a toll, their head's getting stuffed up the mat. So, learning to cut your losses. All right, my setup wasn't great. My shot wasn't perfect. But now I can check my position. I'm gonna slide my hand through his butt, post, try to wrestle out either to the score or to a point where we're back up to our feet and we're neutral. Alright, so I think this is probably an area you'll spend most of your time hitting your shot, defensive guys giving him a good hard feel.
I'm at his knee, now I'm sliding off with it. Off his knee because he's really defending the position. Right, he's really defending the single nice. Alright, but I can't give up on it. I'm not staying locked. I post to maintain a good body position. Like a cat in a fight, my back is hunched, I'm off his knee, I come to his butt. As I slide to his butt, my elbow comes back. I try to lock this hip out if I can. And then I get up on my toes, and my shoulder's driving, and I'm gonna try to re-penetrate my knee around his heel. All right, so as I hustle into him, I'm working hip to hip. My knee comes in front, all the way through. My shoulder's in position, no shin whizzer. There's no shin whizzer because my shoulder is in strong position. I bring this up to the shelf. Then I get my points. All right, so there's a lot of key points in there. Starting with your swing leg, your back leg, your trail leg. Has to get to the corner. I leave it in front, I'm dead in the water. So I sprawl, I leave this in front, I'm in trouble. Right, my hip is just out of position. All right, so I really want to hustle my hip around. My swing leg, really try to hustle. Like a hip to hip. If he gets his leg back, I'm gonna slide up to his butt. I knife his butt, I post. Alright? Post. I'm working hip to hip. My elbow's back. I'm hustling. And then I re-penetrate my knee to the shelf, to my score. Now, if he's really fighting me hard, and I'm having a really hard time getting to the corner, I'm gonna come through the middle with my hand. I don't like coming through the middle with my head. I think it gives him another opportunity to catch my ankles and cause a stalemate. So if I am gonna come back in front of him, as he's squaring up on me, I go with my hand.
I'm circling, trying to get to the corner. I can't get there. He's hustling. Now I'm going to re-penetrate my back leg, driving off my trail leg. My knee's going to come through the middle. And my outside hand is posted. He's going to catch.
All right. So they go together. I'm hustling the corner, but I'm not getting there. I feel like I'm not getting to it. Then I'm going to elbow back. I go with my knee through the middle, and my arm comes through the middle. Heads just shifting. It's real important to maintain a good pat back in that position too. Any questions in there on the mat?
So I really want to get to the corner. But he's fighting hard. Right, I can't hit you, I'm not even on my feet. It's nice if I'm on my feet in this tripod, because now I have more distance to cover. And then I can pull this down.
So I'm really knifing down hard. That time I wasn't at his butt. I was down by his knee. You know, so it's kind of going to be depending on how he's defending me. If he's defending me hard,
I just locked in. I thought he'd be able to just fight out of it from there.
All right, he fought off a good shot. All right, but most of the time, his defense is going to be as solid. He's going to go to a knee. He's going to lose pressure on my head. I get to the corner.
This could be like a hard spar too. It could be a live situation, it could be a hard spar. But your partner's got to be really important. You should talk about that every day. Your partner's part of the practice. It's really, really important. Both guys involved.
It can't catch a shot. It's got two times. I'm sliding on my laces.
Right, I'm working with him.
Right? I'm working with him. He re-penetrates his. That's good. You know, but I can't be like this.
That's too easy. You know, I gotta give him a feel. You know, and that might be the first week of practice teaching.
You gotta give him that feel. You gotta be engaged.
When he's shooting on you,
if I am lunging, see his hips dropped, right? He's on his laces, or he's on his toe. Should be on his laces. All right.
Probably the most popular defense is the shin wizard. All right, and I know it's trickled down to high school. I see it all the time. So guys are willing to give up their hips. All right, they go shin wizard. You know, and this also might even just happen finishing on this side off my shot. All right, so I hit my single.
He defends. All right, his shin wizard. All right, now a lot of guys are coming over with their knee and trying to break his lock. If the guy's good here and he goes here, it's because he's got flexible knees or he just feels comfortable in this position. So you're trying to break this either by pulling his fingers or using your knee. It's probably not going to work.
You'll see this position today. You'll see this today. 149, you'll see it today.
What I recommend, you know, is not coming over the top of that.
Because by coming over, when you come over, you actually help him. He has more flexibility, and then he can limp away.
All right, or he can do that tilt, that jump through tilt. So
he gets his shin whizzer. All right, what I'm doing is I'm going to point myself into him right, on an angle. I'm going to point myself into him on an angle, and I'm going to control this knee. All right, if he's hammering me down hard, right, and weights on my head, all right, now I might have to post my head and re-grab. All right, if he's got a good whizzer and he's just I'm still posted here, I'm okay. Right, my head's not really into the mat yet. But he's starting to gain position because my lock is sliding below his knee down to his ankle. Right, I'm going to lose this shot, whether it's up on my feet or down low. All right, so my post hand becomes important because I'm going to catch his knee. Right where his thigh meets his knee, and I'm going to re-grab over the top. I re-grab over the top. Now I have his knee controlled. He can still have that wizard, that's fine. Now I come back to my post, help me get height. Now from this position, I'm going to go knee to knee. I'm going to change my post leg. And my outside leg is driving into him. I'm going to go knee to knee, switch my knees. My inside leg is going to become my shelf.
Right to that position.
I'm trying to shuffle behind, circle behind him. I don't want to step up into him where he can pick my ankles. All right, so I'm trying to shuffle behind him. And now right here, this is position A, because I can just hook his ankle with my feet and take him down.
Now most guys, they're going to fight up.
Right, it's going to become a more difficult fight. You know, that's ideal. I switch my knees, and then I just I hook. It's almost like I'm in a turf position. Alright, so again, a partner is really important because he's giving you his hip so he can get his knee down and catch his shin. So I hit. Shot. I stepping over, probably not a good option. You guys ever at the Iowa match last year, Ashnault went here, leg in, and limped, and then the kid rolled, and it was a quick two. And they flipped that. I mean, it's probably not the most technically sound position, but I mean, different things work for different guys in a short time. You gotta make something happen. We don't teach that though. You know, I mean, he kinda got in there, he felt it, went for it, needed to take down the win, boom, he got it. So, the ideal position is what we're showing.
If you're looking to name it, just call the knee exchange. Exchange your knees. It's easy for the guys to remember.
And rolls, he goes hard wizard, I post in, comes to his knee. Outside leg's driving, right, so I'm keeping weight into him. Right, weight's into him, my outside hand closing. Knee, right by his thigh, I change hands, control that knee, now my post hand stays up, I'm gonna drive, switch my knees, shuffle, right? If I can, I'll catch this leg. A lot of guys will pop up, he pops up. Controlling his leg. In this position, it's outside my body. I'm gonna go tomahawk, slap, and trip. All right. Sometimes I'll end up in this position where I'm in on his leg and I'm up still by his knee. All right, and I might have to crack him. All right, I gotta be careful as I crack him. He doesn't try to dive through. All right, so if I crack him, I'll stay low, pull him. Realize I'm in control. I'm in control. If he stays down here, he might be trying to bait me, right? For me to step in and he catches my leg. All right, so I did all that work. I don't want to let that happen. So if I'm going to do that, I'm going to keep a hand. I'm controlling his leg, so I'll keep a hand by his shoulder. And then I'll slide up to his crotch and run for my score. All right, but I have to understand that I'm controlling the leg. I'm controlling the position. And at the same time, I have to be cautious that he's not trying to do something to dive through. Catch me at a weak moment. Right. Any questions in there?
You snuck the shoulder snap.
Yeah, definitely.
Not the
Do you want to see the whole thing? There you go, shin wizard. Out the hand post. We grab that knee. As I circle up, he comes to his feet. Now from this position, I crack. And then I slide. I crack and slide. Now I'm baiting him to come up. As he comes up, swap. And the sweeping is important. Sweeping my inside leg. Swap.
Again, don't step. Just really kick the bottom of that foot.
Maybe fall already, you hurt the guy right now. What else did I say? Anything else?
You sure that he changed again?
Yep. Now, a good guy, he's having hard, his knee's in like that. All right, he's trying to come over, maybe help me, or just call him sailmate, or see where my foot is right now. Grab my foot. So, I gotta be cautious. He starts hanging me down. Before I get too far, down his shin, I'm posting and catching. Or even if my head's down, to help me, so I can re-grab, so I can come back. Now I have his knee control. Okay. And then when I go knee to knee, I'm shuffling, my hips are coming in, I'm trying to step all the way over, if I can. Now I can snag that. You'll see that.
You guys end up in that position a lot, shin wizard?
Jim Wizard, everybody's there, right?
How about anything in the shingle where you guys get that you don't really know, or you can want some advice on how to finish?
I've seen a lot of guys get stuck hip tip on the Wizard, when, especially when the guy comes in and he lifts it up. And the other kid on bottom trying to step over and trying to like hook the leg and kick him over.
So he's like almost like bundling him.
Yeah.
He's catching his forearm. So I'm down. He's got a Wizard. He's trying to pull this across.
Yeah.
Like a bundle.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think it's a lot of my shoulder position. I don't see him being able to pull this across his body. My shoulder's into him still. See if my shoulder's still pumping out. So I'm all the way through, my head's down. You might be able to pull me and catch that. But my shoulder's in front.
Chest up.
My head's into him. My back's like a cat. It's a lot of weight on
him. I think it may be more body position. You know, if he catches my arm, I'm not in good shape there. If he got this across, I'm in trouble.
So many guys feel like they got to hold on there. If you watch Burrows now, some of his best tactics, he gets that cat back and obviously gets one in freestyle. He's got really good at run. But you got to separate your hands.
Yeah, it might be because they're locked too. Posting. You know, I think it's important to teach these guys your body position is more important than your hand position. You could be locked on a guy's leg. You'll see it in the first match at 11 o'clock. They're going to be locked. They're going to hold on forever. They're going to get a stalemate. You know, but you're not going to score. You got to separate your hands and fix your body so you can get around.
You ever want to attack that head? Excuse me. You ever want to get the shoe with you? You ever want to attack that head?
Yeah.
I was talking about that earlier in the match.
That's
a party against
Patrick.
Josh Patrick. He was in. And Lepari kind of went lazy D, Shin Wizard, and his head was down, and he went crash cradle, and
you know, that's a really good spot to be in. You know, the one thing to be careful there, I call it crash cradle, I don't know, is that he might be baiting you into that. You know, he could be keeping his head down, thinking that you're gonna drive him, catches your leg. You know, so if you are gonna crash cradle the guy, he's looking in you, just make sure. Your elbows down, you're crunching. If it's an aggressive position, it's a good way to score. You don't want to get ducked under anything, you know. And we'll do, you know, different types of warm-ups, and we'll start in that single, boom, crash cradle, or cross-face cradle. Yeah, exactly, yeah. You kind of...
So he's got this Wizard.
I come like I'm going crash cradle. Now he fell down.
I'm using it as like a fan.
I'm going cradle. And you feel pass.
Yeah. So I'm here. I'm going cradle. Okay.
Right? Right. Lepari does that at 7-7 instead of 14-7. You know? Instead, he fought it. He thought he was going to come through the middle or whatever he thought he was going to do. He ends up on the back. You know, so that's a good option. I've seen Ashmal. He spends a lot of time in here on this Shin Wizard. The guy's down, right? A lot of times he's left, so he's on the other side. But a lot of times he's been able to catch this foot, right? And then other times he gets a real funky guy. He'll catch this leg, right? So, but if I can control his head, he can't get to my leg. So he's been coming like a stiff arm. Come up here, right to the head. And just kind of hustling the guy down.
Yeah, being wary of the head, using that outside head, really controlling the leg, and then just control the ear and the head, and throw the guy down. So that's another option too.
How much time do you actually spend in practice on the funk and counter funk? Like that's the thing that people switch since, you know, back in the day.
Yeah.
You spend actual practice time with your counter, and how much time?
We do a lot of flow wrestling at the beginning and part of the warm-up. And a lot of the times, it's putting yourself in those positions, funk wrestling, you know, diving through, wrestling out of it. And it starts out as a nice little flow, and it turns into a little bit more of a spar. And then obviously, when we really want to get attack the day, we make it a certain block. You know, if that's going to be the block, we make that the block. But every day, we put each other through the crotch, you know, maybe in here, wrestling here, playing. The officers all roll throughs, and so we flow left up. We play in those positions every single day. 10 minutes, not go over all that. Even like double legs, you can hammer a guy with a good double leg, and he's already jumping off trying to go through your crotch and catch your ankle. So we're always telling the guys, be wary of your feet, where your feet are, and your high crotch. You know, if you're going high crotch, you use this leg guy, he's going to come over the top of it.
Here?
Yeah. Well, he